we will continue to bring those stories to life at Shanghai Disneyland in unique and very interesting way.
Hello, Joe. Thank you for your time and thank you for attending our show. Zootopia will open on December 20th. Would you like to share any highlights of the theme land?
Well, we're so excited to bring this land to life for the very first time. This is the first time anywhere in the world that we've debuted Zootopia. And it's for a very specific reason, because this location is so much like our character in the movie, Judy Hopps, coming to the big city of Shanghai for the very first time. So we're very excited for guests to see the immersive details that we have to offer as the story comes to life.
Why did you choose this story for new expansion?
Well, because it is the number one imported animated film of all time in China. It was, something that spoke to people about their journey from the countryside to the big city. And we couldn't think of a better place to bring this immersive story to life for the very first time.
Zootopia is Shanghai Disney Resort's second major expansion since it opened in 2016. Why did Disney expand so rapidly in Shanghai?
Well, it's interesting that you should ask that, because in 2018 we opened Toy Story Land, and 3 years after we opened we announced this development. The reason is because we have huge confidence in this market. The Chinese consumer is so ready for deep immersive experiences, high quality entertainment, and we've been learning over the last several years exactly what the consumer really wants here in China. And we believe that we have chosen stories that are relevant and products and services that are really unique that offer that high quality experience to them.
You know, Disney has a wealth of stories. More stories are brought to Disney's destination across the world. What do you think about this trend? And how has Disney chosen to do this? Will Shanghai Disney Resort introduce more stories in the future?
Yes, so you know that Disney just turned 100 years old. So we have a legacy of storytelling. Those stories reach worldwide audiences, so they're relevant all over the world. And because of that rich history and deep intellectual property rights that we have in terms of various characters and stories, we will continue to bring those stories to life at Shanghai Disneyland in unique and very interesting ways. And we'll continue to bring new franchises, new characters to this beautiful place.
You are a key witness to Shanghai Disney Resort development. What impressed you the most over the past 7 years?
Well, it's incredible to see, and we're incredibly humbled to see how much our consumer has connected with our product. It's a deep emotional experience. Bringing joy and happiness to people's lives is something that we take very seriously. Every detail matters in the things that we do and bringing the stories to life. But the crowd or the audience response has been incredible. And we're incredibly humbled by that response, and know we have to work hard to create these memories that will last a lifetime.
Shanghai Disney Resort is one of the largest foreign investment projects in China's history. How has the resort contributed to China's economy? And how will this new land affect our local community and the local market?
Well, we expect that we'll continue to drive tourism directly to Shanghai. We recognize our role in driving the tourism industry, and we've been very successful, especially over the last year, in driving a lot of that economic benefit to Shanghai. As a new tourist comes to Shanghai, everybody benefits from that. We want to help Shanghai be the most visited location in all of China when it comes to coming to come and visit.
You've been in China for several years. What are your feelings on China's business climate?
Well, I can tell you that it's wide open in terms of the opportunities We regard Shanghai as a very dynamic city, very international city, and wide open to the possibilities, which is very exciting for us because as we see possibilities, we can work really hard to be able to develop those because we know there'll be an audience for it. We know Shanghai is one of the more cosmopolitan cities in the entire world. And we want to help Shanghai to continue to grow in that consumer expectation.
Do you like Shanghai?
Oh, I love Shanghai.
What did you do during your spare time?
What do? I walk a lot around the city and visit various destinations around the city. I like to see how people interact with different things. New restaurants. I love to go and visit new restaurants, new scenic locations. That's where I spend a lot of my time.
You are nearly at the end of this year. How did the Shanghai Disney Resort perform in 2023?
We were very fortunate to be a top destination when it came to tourism. So this last year has been incredibly successful with the number of people who wanted to come back and do something with their family and friends. I think reconnecting is something that is really important for people, that sense of companionship, bringing joy and happiness to people's lives and a place to celebrate and be a part of this multi-day destination is something that we're incredibly proud of in this last year and couldn't be more happy about that.
So looking ahead, what chances have you seen from Chinese market and what are your new plans for the future?
So we have been really excited to see the response to the things that we've done so far. We announced this project 3 years after. We've already started on our next hotel, which will be a themed hotel right next to the Disneyland Hotel. And we have many more plans from there, but you just have to stay tuned to find out what's next. What I can tell you for certain is that we're going to continue to bring new stories to life, new experiences for people to want to come back time and time again, because that's the job that we do.
Okay, thank you so much, Jill. Thank you.
It's our pleasure.